בואו בבקשה לקינה.
They produce fruits. Our olives are very famous. We make from it oil. If you want to have a very private synagogue, would you like to have a look at it?
Yep.
Very old. They come from different communities. Your Holiness, I'm privileged to welcome you on behalf of the State of Israel, of our people. You came for a holy purpose, among other things, also to support peace, a religious peace between you and the Pope, which is very important, and also to support the political peace in the Middle East, all over the places. I think the religious authorities that are going to meet the political establishment may really help to find a solution and a compromise between all the conflicting parties in the Middle East. And unfortunately, there is no other land that knew so much holiness and so many conflicts. And we have to save the holiness from the hands of the conflicting confrontations. In Israel, there are many holy places, and our government feels it is our responsibility to guarantee the free approach to every holy site, the safety of all the pilgrimages, of all the prayers that are coming, to enable each of them to pray to the Lord in his own language, from his own praying book, and without any inconveniences and censorship. Everybody is equal, and each of us can be equal. The right to be equal includes the equal right to be different. And I'm very glad that our relations, both with the Vatican and your patriarchy, is in a very good shape. And we really serve the Lord, who is on the side of peace, and not the claim of a Lord that is on the side of murder.
First of all, I would like to thank Your Excellency for this warm welcome. On behalf of my colleagues and myself, this time, as you know, Your Excellency, we came with His Holiness the Pope in order to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the historic meeting in this Holy Land of our great predecessors, Pope Paul VI and Patriarch Athinagoras, who opened a new way in our bilateral relations. Since we have lifted the anathemas among our churches, we have established a theological dialogue between Catholicism and Orthodoxy, but also to contribute to a establishing a permanent peace around the globe. This is the conviction of the Ecumenical Patriarchate that unity among faiths will be very important for unity and peace around the globe. So we shall continue to pray and to work for peace. Thank you once again.